Welcome to physics lesson, linear motion, ticker timer. It's one of the methods that we use to measure and find acceleration. As far as you have the final velocity and you have the initial velocity, then you can get the acceleration. From our previous lesson, we said that acceleration is the rate of change of velocity, meaning, first of all, before you take you get acceleration, you must find the change in velocity and the time it takes for that velocity to change. So ticker timer is one of the ways, use of a ticker timer is one of the ways that we always use to find acceleration. A ticker timer is actually a machine that uses alternating current. We have two types of current, we have the direct current and we have the alternating current. Remember, alternating current is a current that flows with reverse in a given frequency. So ticker timer majorly uses AC current. Now, what happens is, for a ticker timer to be used, there must be a tape. That tape is always this way. And ticker timer makes dots on the tape. Then those dots being made on the tape are the ones that we can use to find the acceleration. Then we have a trolley that pulls the tape, or any other object that can pull the tape. The tape, or the dots on the tape, actually tells us the speed of that particular object. If the dots are equally spaced all through, it means that the object was moving with a constant velocity. But if the spaces between the dots keep on varying, also it shows that the velocity was varying with time. Now, also we have different types of ticker timer based on their frequencies. But the most common ones we use are the one with a frequency of 50 Hz and frequency of 100 Hz. If a ticker timer is having a frequency of 50 Hz, first of all, we need to interpret this. What do we mean by saying that a frequency, I mean a ticker timer has a frequency of 50 Hz? It means what? It means that it can make 50 dots per second. So, it can make 50 dots per second. Now, the question is, in one dot, what will be the time? So, if this 50, it can make 50 dots in 1 second, then one dot can be made in which time? Then it's going to be 1 over 50, which is going to be 0.02 seconds. Then we have another frequency. Ticker timer of 100 Hz frequency, then it means it is making 100 dots per second. So it's going to make one dot in 1 over 100 in 0.01 seconds. So these are very important. Frequencies of ticker timers are very important, and everyone who wants to get the acceleration using a frequency must know what is the frequency of the ticker timer. It's very important. Now, look here, you need to look at the following. I want to draw three tapes being pulled by a trolley in a ticker timer. Then from there, we can discuss which tap is moving with a uniform velocity or constant velocity, which one moves with increasing velocity, and which one moves with decreasing velocity. So the first one is there. The second one is here. I name this A, I name this B, I name this C. Then, when you are given a tape in a ticker timer, always the direction has to be shown by use of an arrow. That way, we have to use an arrow to show you which direction was the tape being pulled, so that you can know where to locate or where to find the initial and final velocity. So the second one is this. Then we have the last one. So let me start with the first one. The spaces, the spacings between the dots appears to be equally spaced. So meaning the first one was being pulled by a trolley that was moving with a uniform velocity. The second one, the spaces were very short during the start, but at the end, the spaces increases, meaning the trolley was moving with increasing velocity. Then the last one here, the spaces were very wide, but at the end, it becomes very small, meaning the velocity was decreasing. These arrows are the ones that shows you where it started. Now, in this case, this one is the one that started. In the second one, part B, where I've just shown you is the one that started. And by the end of it, it was moving very fast. Why am I saying it was moving very fast? You don't need to confuse. When the spaces are so wide, then it was moving very fast. When the spaces are close to each other, it was moving with low velocity, because the ticker timer makes dots, basing on its frequency without changing. Whatever it changes, there's a carbon paper that makes dots. Whatever it changes is the velocity of the depth being pulled. So if it moves very fast, then by the time the ticker timer makes a dot and repeats another one, then the space will be very wide. That's why we are saying here, it was starting with a very high velocity, but it ended up with a very small velocity. So the spacings actually are the one that tells you or guides you to know when or what was the velocity in it. That is it. Let's move to the last part of the ticker timer now, on how can we use a ticker timer to calculate acceleration. I will show you in two ways. Starting from the simple one, one that I can't expect each one of you to fail to get it. This one, for example. First of all, I will show you my direction. That it was being pulled in that given direction. Upper, I will just give you the frequency was 50 hertz. So now what is remaining is for me to give you the dots. I will give you several dots here. We have one, we have two, we have three, we have four, five, and six. Then I will give you part A and B here. Then I will give you C and B. Then I give you the distance between A and B as 10 centimeters. This one I can give it to be 15 centimeters. So from there, we can find our initial velocity and the final velocity. Where the arrow is pointing, that A, now in this case AB is the one that will give you the initial velocity. CD will give you the final velocity. And remember, velocity is, when you get the distance or the displacement over the time. In this case, we have 10 centimeters and 15 centimeters. Now the question is, what is the time between A and B? The time is what we say, it comes from the frequency. If the ticker timer is of 50 hertz, then the time between two successive dots is going to be 0.02 seconds. Then, another thing that you need to know very well concerning ticker timer, we know that the speed is given in meters per second. Now, ticker timer, under special conditions, it can give you the speed in centimeters per second. No offense, no problem with that. But I always encourage you to give us in meters per second. So you convert 10 centimeters into meters, you convert 15 centimeters into meters, then you get your speed here. Now, the initial velocity, I told you we always use U. So it's going to be given by 10 centimeters into meters is going to be 0.1 over the time which is 0.02. You get your answer over there. You proceed to this other one, 0.15 over the time which is 0.02. I will not go into completion because you will do it. Then after that, you will get your final velocity here, which is denoted by V. Then now, you get your final velocity, come down here, follow your workings, then acceleration is given by V minus U over T. Let me assist you how to get this T, because V, you'll get it here, U, you'll get it here. Now T, this is where you need to be very keen, and look at it very clearly. Time is given we have to take the half or the average of the time from here. The first one, we have to get the half of the time between AB, half of the time between C and D. Then we get the time now between where we are getting the average, I mean the initial and final velocities. In this case, we have here is 1, we have 2, we have 3, then take half from here and take half from here. So it's going to be 4 spaces because I'm taking half from here and half from here, then I add the 3, it becomes 4. So my time is going to be 4, then times what we had said, 0.02. From there, you will get your acceleration. That is the first and the simplest ticker timer. Let me show you the one now that somehow looks complicated, but also very simple. The second one, which I want you to look at it, is the same way, but now it has many dots. So I will put here to be my A, B, I put here to be C, and then D. So as you can see, it is varying from the first one, where to get the initial velocity and the final velocity are having very many dots, which sometimes students may not know how to get the average time. So what still remains, if here, for example, is 20 centimeters, then the other part B is 30 centimeters. What you are supposed to do, just get the initial velocity, you have the distance which is 20 centimeters, and the ticker timer can be your frequency, 100 hertz, meaning for every dot, it's going to take 0.01 seconds. Then, the time here, because it is 2 spaces, it's going to be 0.01 times 2. The time here is going to be 1, 2, 3, 0.01 times 3. Then, it is very simple to get the final and initial velocities. But now, if you want to get the time, if you want to get the time here, what are you supposed to do? First of all, we have 1, we have 2, then half of AB, which is 3, half of between C and D, 1, 2, 3, half of it is going to be 1.5 because there are 3. So for me to get the total time, I will take 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 and a half. That's going to be 4.5. Then how times our periodic time, which is 0.01. Then if you get this time, it will now assist you to apply our formula A equals to V minus U, is U over T. So that is how you are supposed to do. Follow my next lesson for calculations on ticker timer. Thank you.